What's going on?
I think my friend here's having a heart attack.
Okay, let's get her to bank four. Ma'am, I'm gonna have you take a seat, okay?
Her complaint was basically that she was having chest pain, shortness of breath, palpitations, and sweating. She had a male companion there, and he appeared to be quite a bit younger than her.
Hello, ma'am. I'm Dr. Turner.
And I'm Austin. I'm Susan's personal trainer, certified. Is she okay?
Her symptoms were classic for an acute heart attack.
This EKG should tell us a lot. But tell me, what were you doing when your chest pain started?
I was out having, was on a run with Austin. And then I had to stop suddenly because my heart started beating so fast.
Her phone rang several times.
Austin's phone.
Who is that?
Nothing, I'll talk to you about it later.
You and all your secrets.
Do you have a history of hypertension, diabetes?
No, I don't.
Well, you are approaching that age where heart disease is an increased risk for women.
Oh boy, a sweet talker. Bet you're great with all the ladies.
Don't tell his wife.
I meant no disrespect. I was just going through the risk factors. We're gonna have to do some tests, rule out other causes, pulmonary embolism, aortic dissection. But your symptoms are most consistent with something going on with your heart.
So when I looked at the EKG, I mean, it was absolutely completely normal.
I doubt that you're having a heart attack.
Well, that takes care of that. Thank you, doctor. We'll be on our way.
Oh, not so fast. I just said that the EKG looks normal.
The heart is a muscle. It needs nutrients in order to work. Anything that restricts the amount of nutrients that get to the heart will threaten its viability.
Right now you're at rest. What we have to do is reproduce the situation in which you are having your symptoms. I suggest you have a stress test.
I had to explain to her how important getting these tests were.
This could be signs of cardiac ischemia.
And I said, are you taking medications for any medical problems? And she said she wasn't taking any prescribed medications, but that she had gotten a medication from a health food store that was supposed to be an energy boost.
Do you have that with you?
I don't.
Several of the supplements have stimulants in them, and they can make your heart beat faster.
I forget the name of it.
I asked her, is there any possibility that we could find out what that medication was?
I can go get them, it's not that far.
My keys are at my bars.
So how many times do you run a week?
Well, to be honest, before today, I haven't gone in 3 years.
What?
You know, his eyebrows sort of raised.
You haven't gone running in 3 years? Babe, why don't you tell me?
I didn't want to pressure you. Or make you feel self-conscious.
Well, any more than I am right now?
That was peculiar to me. That shouldn't have been that much of a surprise to him.
Why can't you just tell the doctor the truth and come clean with it?
Okay, okay. Here's what really happened.
Welcome to Austin, baby.
Well, thank you. It's my first time.
Everything's bigger in Texas.
She indicated something about him having a lot of stamina, and so it probably went on for a little period.
Something's wrong. My chest is pounding. Something's pounding in my chest. I think I'm having a heart attack.
There's a lot of other issues that her revelation about having the chest pain during sex created. Heart disease is the main thing that I'm focusing on.
Yeah, Susan can't talk right now. She's in the hospital. There, I fixed it.
Who was that?
Well, parents, you know what's important.
Austin, could you go get the supplements, please?
They're on the kitchen counter. No need to look anywhere else.
She did almost admonish him, make sure you go right in and come right back out because the doctor needs to know, but it seemed like she was more concerned about him taking time and going through the house.
Doctor, the patient's labs are in.
These all look normal.
Given the results of all her lab tests, it heightened my desire to have the results of the stress test so that I could further rule out the possibility that she was having a true cardiac event.
Where is Austin and those stupid pills? I feel like a hamster.
Keep going, just a few minutes more.
Doctor, the patient has a visitor.
Craig?
She seemed to be a little upset when she saw this guy come in.
Leave me alone! What are you doing here?
You've been ducking my calls all day. Then some guy answers and says you're in the hospital. This is the only thing that would keep you from enjoying a good mediation.
My attorney will not approve of us meeting like this, and I am not enjoying this divorce. But it just has to be done.
We don't have to get a divorce. That's you. I'm not leaving until I find out what's happening. Legally, you're still my wife.
I was just out for a run, and I thought I was having a heart attack. So I'm doing a stress test, and you're not helping any.
Susan, do you want this guy to stay?
Here we go. They're in the kitchen, right where you said.
Who are you?
Who are you?
I'm her husband.
Austin is my personal trainer.
Oh, how much does that cost me per hour?
This old geezer is your husband? Oh, I think you definitely traded up.
Soon to be ex-husband. I'm getting a divorce. I'm leaving him.
She's got this young stud.
So I'm getting your day-old leftovers.
Huh. He's got to be the old stud instead of the young stud.
You're calling my wife leftovers?
Olga! And they were going at each other.
It's happening again! Oh my God!
I'm gonna have to ask both of you to leave right now.
Grabs to the first punch. Jim Rat insulted my wife.
But my concern was with the patient. And I said, is this the way you felt before? And she said, yes. And so I instructed the nurse to repeat her EKG, because this was a perfect opportunity to capture what was going on with the heart right at the moment that she was having her symptoms. And it should give me as much information as I was going to get.
Well, I'm happy to report that despite your symptoms, your EKG is normal.
How could it be normal? My hands are still shaking. Boy, did I get busted.
ER drama's not that uncommon, I'm sorry to say.
She was still anxious about what might be going on in the waiting room. We made sure that the security guard stayed and made sure that they stayed separate.
So what's up with the supplements?
Well, it looks like these are just vitamins. Nothing that should increase your heart rate. But I do have one more question for you. While you were having sex today, was there anything else going on that might have been stressing you out?
Yes, there kind of was. Yeah, there was.
Right in the middle of our lovemaking, I realize my wedding picture is still on the desk, so I place it face down. And then I see our divorce papers on the desk, so I shove them off.
Something's wrong. My chest. It's pounding. Something's pounding in my chest. I think I'm having a heart.
And right after that is when I started to feel the pain and labored breathing.
Well, knowing the real story, I think I've figured this out.
Well, don't leave me in the dark, doctor. I need to know.
Her heart showed stellar performance through everything that occurred.
Physically, I think your heart is fine. I think you were having a panic attack.
It's often difficult to tell the difference between a panic attack and a heart attack.
And anything that creates stress can trigger the same symptoms.
And having sex for the first time in 3 years, that was one of those triggers.
And I said that I don't think her physical ability to accommodate sex was the problem.
I think the trigger was your hiding the fact from Austin that you were married. But you were right to come in today. You could have actually been having a heart attack.
Nope, the nurse wants you to stay.
Okay.
How long have you been married?
15 years.
You have two very impatient men in the waiting room. Which one do you want me to bring back?
Gentlemen, Susan has chosen you.
Ha! Ugh, I need to go to push-ups!